Okay, next tayo sa pasyente may peptic ulcer disease. When you say exacerbation, grow magrabe. Okay. Asan kaya dyan? Ang option na pwede magpagrabe. Letter A. Tama. Nakatulog siya lang maayos. Walang problema dyan. Eating 5-6 meals per day. Okay lang, di ba? 3 main meals, tapos merienda in between. Ability to work at home, okay lang yan. Ang nakakasama will be letter D. Bakit? Pabago-bagong schedule. Na-stress yung pasyente mo. Okay? Stress can also be a risk factor of ulcer. Okay? Yan, letter D. Let's go sa ating 402. Infection control methods. Okay? Most effective to prevent hepatitis. Yan. Of the following infection control methods, which would most effectively prevent hepatitis? Hand washing will only minimize. Okay? Yan. Immunoglobulin, no. Late na yan. Okay? Same with letter C. Proper personal hygiene, it will only minimize. Mice, yung pinaka-best is vaccine talaga. Okay? Yan, again, A and C will minimize. Alam mo yung minimize? Okay? Asawa ni Mickey Mouse. Okay, ayan lang. Ayan, 403. 403 tayo. Okay. A nurse provides home care. Okay? Instruction to a client with Hepa B. Okay. Which statement made by the client indicates the best? Ibig sabihin, naintindihan niya. Okay. So, A, B, C, or D. Ito ah, transmission. Ibig sabihin, hindi na maikalat. Letter A, hindi yan. Kasi you focus on the patient. And it will be letter D. The wife should get the vaccine. To minimize transmission, di ba? Yan, okay? Letter D. Okay, 404 tayo. Dito, the nurse is caring for a client with cirrhosis. Okay? At meron dito tawag na portal hypertension. Pag sabing portal hypertension, there's too much blood pressure or nagsisikulit ang dugo sa ating liver. Dahil sobrang lakas, okay? Sobrang lakas ng pressure doon. Sa ating liver. Okay? The other fluid might go to the other parts of the body. Sa ating peritoneum, ascites, ibang fluid naman, sa lungs. See? Letter D. Okay? Minsan sa sobrang lakas ng pressure sa liver, pati yung ating esophagus, karoon siya ng mga yung veins niya nagbabulge. We call it esophageal varices. Okay? Anyway, for this question, answer will be letter D. Crackles and auscultation of the lungs. Okay? Dallas. Okay, 405 naman tayo. 405. So, a nurse is developing, okay, a plan of care sa taong may cirrhosis and ascites. Remember, ang ascites, lumalaki yung chan niya kasi may fluid. Hindi naman chan yung abdominal area. Ano yung avoid? Avoid, avoid. Letter D. Avoid in a supine position because the fluid sa peritoneal cavity, mabigat, madaganan yung diaphragm, hindi siya makahinga. Okay? Yan, Dallas. Okay? Let's go tayo sa ating 406. Yan. Unang sismonitoring a client with cirrhosis. Okay? For hepatic encephalopathy. Ano daw ang earliest sign? Okay, answer will be Boston. Okay, once na ang pasyente mo nag-hand flapping, okay? Nag-hand flapping. There's already ammonia in the blood. At kapag ang ammonia mapunta sa brain ng patient, pwede siyang ma-comatose. So, yun ang ating pwedeng maiwasan. Hepatic encephalopathy. Letter C. Letter B, asterisk. To avoid hepatic encephalopathy, we need to decrease ammonia levels, diba? Ayan. Anyway, letter B is the answer. 407 tayo. 407. GERD. Okay. Anong parts of the digestive system daw? Answer will be letter C. Lower esophageal sphincter. Ito po yun, ha? Ito yung ating stomach, esophagus, stomach, duodenum, ayan. Ayan. Ito, siya ay open. Kaya pwedeng mag-backflow. Open yung ating lower esophageal sphincter. Kaya nag-backflow. Minsan naman, sarado din ito. Itong ating pyloric sphincter. Kaya yung mga kinakain, hindi makapasok. Kapag wala ibang lalabasan, dito lalabas. Diba? Yan. Letter C is the answer. O, no. So, go number 408 tayo. Delayed emptying. Okay? Kaya sabi ko kanina, answer will be letter A. Pyloric sphincter is the answer. Okay, next number tayo, 409. Okay. Ito na naman tayo, cyano, cobalamin, or vitamin B12. Okay, intrinsic factor. Okay, a client has been diagnosed, the gastrectomy is not producing enough intrinsic factor. You interpret that a client has lost the ability to absorb. Absorb. Ang stomach, dyan po, napoproduce yung intrinsic factor. Okay? At siya ay na-absorb sa letter B, intestines. So, walang pakialam ang colon and large intestines. Okay? Answer will be letter, ma-absorb siya sa letter B, small intestines, absorb. Kasi dapat siya ay ma-produce sa stomach lang. Produce sa production sa stomach. Ang tanong kasi is absorb eh. Letter B. O, 410 tayo. Hepa B. What activity order should the nurse expected? Guys, pag may hepatitis ang pasyente, automatically, meron siyang fatigue. Okay? So, meron siyang bed rest. Okay? Bed rest. Let's go sa ating 411. Meron daw infection yung extremity ng patient. Obviously, meron siyang hot spot. Mainit. Okay? Letter C. 412. A client has closed fracture at may cast sa arm niya. Tapos may pain. Yung elevated the limb, may ice bag siya at may analgesic na nang walang relief. You interpret that this pain may be caused by what? It is not infection. Okay? Before siya magkaroon ng infection at meron mo ng organism, di ba? It's not anxiety. It's letter C. Impaired tissue perfusion. Why? Ito yung patient. Ayan. Yung buto niya. May fracture. Okay. Tapos, yung cast. Napakasikip ng cast. Yan ha? Yan yung cast. Napakasikip ng cast. Ayan. It's covering the cast. Ayan. Hinati ko lang. Sobrang sikip. What about the arteries here? Arteries here. What about the capillaries? Kapag sobrang naiipit, pati yung mga artery, naiipit. Naiipit din sila. Sila ay naiipit. Kaya kung walang blood supply, masakit. Okay? Yan. Answer will be, letter C, impaired tissue perfusion. Walang perfusion dito. Okay. 413. Multiple trauma. Meron siyang leg fracture. Okay. In positioning the casted leg, you should what? Answer will be letter D. Dallas. Okay. sa mga cast, amputations, amputations, sa mga cast, amputation, fractures, dislocation na naayos na. Okay? Ito ba? Tandaan nyo palaging three words. Elevate. Then flat. Then prone. Bakit po yun? Ito yung arm ng patient. Ayan, elevate mo ng konti. Ayan. Kahit nakapatulong sa table, ayan, or sa chair, ayan, elevate. For the first 1 or 2 days. Okay? After 1 or 2 days, you may now flat. What do you mean flat? Ayan, flat. Okay, independent lang. Ayan, flat. Pero, during flat, pag may time, okay, igalaw-galaw mo. To avoid what? Compartment syndrome. To avoid compartment syndrome. When you say compartment syndrome, ito yung extremity ng pasyente. Ito yung katawan niya. Ayan, ito yung ulo niya. Ayan. Okay? Meron siyang, let's say, fracture. Ayan. Tapos, meron siyang cast. Meron siyang cast. Ayan. Hindi niya ginagalaw. Mamamaga, 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 mamamaga. Mamamaga ng mamamaga. Ito namang cast. Sobrang sikip. Sobrang sikip. Nag-aaway yung dalawang force. Ang naiipit is yung PMS ng pasyente. PMS. Nawawala ang kanyang pulse. Nawawala ang kanyang motor. Nawawala ang kanyang sensation. Okay, that's what you call compartment syndrome. Kaya to avoid compartment syndrome, three words. Elevate for the first 1 to 2 days. Flat mo after 2 days or 1 day. Then, prone pag may time. Diba? You just move the fluid sa fracture na yan. Okay? Anyway, 413 until will be letter D. 414 tayo. 414. May skin irritation daw sa cast ng patient. What will you do? Until there will be letter A. How is that? Okay? Ito yung cast ng patient. Ayan. Ito yung cast ng patient. Ito yung kamay niya. Ayan. Minsan may mga sinulid sa cast, di ba? Sinulid. Ito yung cast, ha? Ayan. Ito yung cast. No? Ayan. Yan yung cast. Minsan may mga sinulid. At it can cause irritation to the patient. Ang gawin mo as a nurse, okay? You cut. Sir, how? Paano ko ipipetal? Ayan. Ay, sorry. Ayan. Paano ko ipetal? Simple lang. You cut the cast na parang paganyan. I-cut mo siya paganon. Then, after nyan, yung mga cast, i-fold mo palabas. I-fold mo siya palabas. Bale, yung magiging labas ng cast ngayon is, parang siya ay naka-fold na. Parang gumanyan na siya. Finold mo. Para yung lalabas na surface dito is yung smooth. Hindi natatama. Kumbaga, it's like yung sleeve. Finold mo lang palabas. Diba? That's what they call petal. Okay? Don't use a rough file. May infect. Lotion. Walang order ng doctor. No order. Kaya letter A. Petal it. Okay. 415 tayo. The nurse determines that the client understands proper cast. Pag sinabi niyang bawal. Okay? Avoid the cast getting wet. Okay? Tama yan. Okay? Letter A. 46 tayo. Crutches. Bakit hindi pwedeng mag-rest yung crutch? Okay. Ito yun, ha? Ito yung ating patient. Naka-crutch siya. Yan. Ito yung kamay niya, ha? Yung kamay niya, in-extend ko lang. Ito yung kanyang katawan. Ayan. Yung crutch, ayan, dapat between this one, dapat 2 inches. Bawal Bawal. Bawal na mag-rest yung crutch sa kilikili. Kasi may nerve dito. Ang pangalan ng nerve ay brachial plexus nerve. Ay kapag yan naipit, itong kamay na ito, pwedeng ma-paralyze. Tawag doon, crutch palsy. And it will be letter B. Okay? Yan, letter B. 417. Crutch safety. Okay? Maghanap ka ng maling option dyan. Okay? Yan. Letter A. Letter B. Letter C. Letter D. I will not use this crutch. Totoo. Kasi kanang-kanang measurement. You have your own measurement sa kilikili. The crutch teeth should be inspected periodically. Yung dulo ng crutch, yes, tama, to assess kung sira na. Kasi rubber siya, goma siya. They need to have spare. Dapat may extra ako. Tama yan. Alam mo, nurse, kahit basa, hindi ako madulas. No. Kasi will be letter B. Lahat ng basa, nadudulas. Yun lang naman, di ba? Okay, 418 tayo. Meron siya, fat embolus after fracture. Which of the following data would the nurse evaluate? The most favorable na nawawala na ang embolism. Obviously, sa mga makikita yan, di ba sa lungs, okay? You will see na clear na yung kanyang lungs. Letter B. Okay, 419. Ang sabi dito, okay, you would assess specifically for which of the following signs and symptoms because the diabetes. Ah, okay. Ma'am, meron ka bang diabetes? Okay. Kasi meron kang sa iyong amputation, okay, yan. Sa iyong paa, okay, meron kang hemorrhage. No. Hindi prakit may hemorrhage, meron siyang diabetes, di ba? Ma'am, siguro meron kang diabetes, ano? Kasi sa pa, meron yung stump mo, merong edema. No. Okay? Ma'am, siguro meron kang diabetes. Kasi yung nangumula ang incision, that's infection. Answer will be letter D. Remember, matagal gumuling ang sugat. Kaya yung mga balat niya, madali mag-separate. Okay? Yan, dapat nagdidikit-dikit. Okay? Ayan. Letter D. 420. Amputation. Guys, natanggal po yung bandage. Kung natanggal yung bandage, edi ibalik mo lang naman, i-re-wrap mo. Okay? Yeah, that's our answer. Next, 421 tayo. A client is complaining of low back pain. Low back pain. Nag-reverse siya. Kailan nag-reverse ang low back pain? Kapag bending or lifting. Okay? Bed rest, walang pain yan. Application of heat na may minimize yung pain. Okay? Bending tayo. 422. Arthritis. Yan. Answer will be letter A. Okay? Hindi letter B. Kasi malayo ang energy sa appetite and weight gain. It's letter A. Guys, mayroon dalawang arthritis ha. Mayroong rheumatoid. Mayroong osteoarthritis. Okay. Listen properly. Pag sinabing rheumatoid and osteo, ito po yon.
Rheumatoid. Small bones. Yan.
Pero pag sinabing osteo, big bones. Example po dito sa ating
rheumatoid. Okay? Small bones. Mga fingers. Ayan. Wrist bone. Ayan. Pero kapag
osteo, big bones. Ayan yung mga hips. Knees. Oh, look, ito ah.
Rheumatoid, 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 toy, 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 toy.
Bilateral, both sides, both fingers, both wrists. Pero kapag sinabing osteo, osteo, wo, 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 one, 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 one side. One side ng hip or one side ng knee. Okay? Yan. Anyway, letter A is the answer. Fatigue. Okay. 4, 2, 3. You will see here na meron siyang gout. Obviously, kapag gout is uric acid na. Okay? Guys, ang normal value ng gout is 4.0 hanggang 8.5. Mataas na po ng 1.1, diba? Ayan. So, letter B. 4 to 4. Ang pasyente mo meron siyang osteoarthritis. So, which of the following is a clinical manifestation associated with disorder? You will learn more later. Morning stiffness, kaya kwan yan.
Rheumatoid.
Yan. Ito namang letter B. Decrease, it should be slightly elevated. Slight lang, slight. Okay? Yan. Pero hindi yan ang common manifestation. Ang pinakamaganda ay will be letter C. Okay? Yan. Elevated antinuclear bodies, it happens kay
rheumatoid arthritis.
Yan. Kay RA. Next naman tayo. 4 to 5. 4 to 5. Fractured left hip. Fractured left hip. The client had surgery to repair fractured left hip. You obtain which of the following most important items from the unit storage area to use when repositioning the client from side to side in bed. Guys, eliminate letter D, trapeze, and bed pillow. Kasi meron dalawa dito opposing options. Doctor or a doctor splint. Anyway, the answer will be letter A. Ab, doctor. Paano yun? Ito yun, ha? Ito yung patient. Ito yung kanyang paa. A splint na ilalagay mo sa gitna. Okay? Para mag-open yung paa niya. Para mag-ab. Ab, doc. Okay? Yan. Ano ba itong letter B? Okay? Ito yung patient. Ito yung kamay niya. Ito yung kamay niya. Ito yung paa niya. You put something here in between para yung paa niya mag-adak. Okay? Sir, nahihirapan ako. Oh, ab. Ab. Duck. And adak. Ab. 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 Bu. Buka. Ibig sabihin, bubuka. Okay? I mean, bubuka. Bubuka yung paa. Okay? Kaya kapag adak, 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 adidikit. Adidikit. Meaning, yan. Tapos didikit. Diba? Get the point? Ito naman bubuka. Ito naman didikit. Okay? Abadak, abubuka. Adak, adidikit. Answer will be America. To avoid dislocation ng balakang. Okay. 4, 2, 6. Meron siyang traction. Self-care deficit. You observe. The nurse evaluates the plan of care and determines that which of the following observations indicates a successful outcome. Answer will be look at A. The client allows the nurse to complete the care on daily basis. No. Kalaman lang, hindi wala ng independence yung patient. Diba? Kailangan yung independence. The client allows the family to assist in care. Again, independence. Walang independence. Independence sa patient side. Okay. Next. The client receives care. No. Diba? Ignore. Na-ignore tuloy. Next will be, the client assists. Oh, diba? Meron siyang assistance. Tumutulong yung pasyente as much as possible. Answer will be Dallas. Okay. 427. Body cast. Oh, ito yung pasyente. Ayan. Ito yung kanyang cast. Ayan. Ito yung kanyang kamay. Ayan. So, lahat ito cast. Cast yan. Except, butas po dito ha. Butas po yan. Para dyan siya iihi. Okay? Yan siya iihi. Yung catheter whatsoever. Now, psychosocial adjustment of the client to the cast. Client to the cast. Client cast. Ang keyword, client and the cast. The client and the cast. Okay? Yan, the client and the cast. A, type of transportation, no. Walang, oh, may client. Pero what about the cast, di ba? That will be ability to perform ADL. No, client pa rin yan. Paano yung cast? Answer will be letter C. Sensory stimulation. Bakit? It's between the client and the cast. It's between what? Sensation. Ikaw ba naman maipit yung buong katawan mo? Di ba? Yan. We have what you call a body cast syndrome. Kasi na-feeling ng pasyente din siya magagalaw dahil may cast. But actually, he can still move in the distal parts. Okay? Yan. Letter C is the answer. Okay. 428. Madali lang ito. Minimizing the risk of osteoporosis. Answer will be letter A. Yogurt. Okay? Anyway, kasi meron siyang, obviously, calcium from dairy products. Okay. 429. To prevent frozen shoulder. Ang sabi ko kanina, yung three words, elevate, flat, prone. Answer will be letter B. Lift the shoulder. Okay? Letter B is the answer. Okay. Let's go sa ating 430. Now, you are performing neurovascular. Okay? Neurovascular. Nerves, vascular, blood vessels. Okay, yan. So, the nurse knows the difference of edema. 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 Tandaan ha, edema. Yan. Arterial, no, you will only see edema sa letter C. Pinus return. Okay, ito kasi yan. We have a memory cue called van. Okay? Yan. Vein. Artery. Nerve. Pag may problema si vein, we can see edema. Pag may problema si artery, you can see color problem, temperature problem, or sometimes pain problem. Kapag may problema ang nerve, the patient may sense being numb or numbness or sometimes paresthesia. Okay, paresthesia is parang pins and needles. Okay, yan. So, answer there will be letter C. Kasi may problema siya sa vein, van. Tandaan palagi ang van. Okay, vein, artery, nerve. Okay. 431 tayo. A client is complaining of knee pain. The knee is swollen, red and warm to touch. The nurse interprets that the client's symptoms are not compatible. Not compatible. Hala, red, warm to touch, malamang compatible siya, inflammation. Siguro may injury to. Compatible to. Infection, oo. Degenerative, tumatanda? No. Not compatible will be letter B. Okay, degenerative disease. Next, 432 naman tayo. Mm-hmm. The right leg may be broken. The right leg may be broken. And will be immobilized muna. Steady, di ba? Huwag siyang gagalaw. More movement may cause complication. Okay, Dallas. Okay, 433. Which of the following is unnecessary? Hindi na kailangan sa casting room. Answer will be letter C. Wala pong anesthesia dyan. Okay? Wala pong anesthesia. There's no anesthesia. Okay? Letter C. Oh, sorry. Yan. 434 naman tayo. Okay. You are, nurse suggested the exercises sa isang taong may right skeletal traction. Nurse determines that the client needs further instruction. Maghanap ka ng maling sinabi. Okay? Yan. A, B, C, D. Yan. Pulling up the trapeze. It's okay. Kasi, yung pasyente mo, ang problema niya is yung paa. Pero, yung trapeze naman is nasa kama yan. Di ba? Yung parang bakal na hinihila ng pasyente para siya ay makataas. It's okay. Flexing and extending the feet. It's okay. Flex, extend lang naman. Kasi ang problema naman yung buto dito, kahit igalaw-galaw niya ito, okay na naman. Hindi naman gumagalaw yung buong leg. Diba? Feet lang yan. Okay? Okay lang yan. Ano yung mali? C or D? Ah, look at Dallas. Performing quadriceps. Okay lang. Bakit? Pwet niya po ang nag-exercise. Pero letter C? Wow! Performing active ROM to the right ankle and knee. Ibig sabihin yung buong paa niya ginagalaw-galaw mo. Okay? Ito yung paa ng pasyente. Ayan. Tapos may mga bakal-bakal. Tapos sige, galaw. Ginagalaw-galaw mo. Ito yung needs for further instruction. Okay? Letter C is the answer. Okay, 435. A client has a slight weakness on the right leg. Okay. The nurse determines that the client would most benefit from the use of what? Guys, A, B, C, D. A slight weakness kasi ang walker pwedeng both legs dapat ang weak. Okay? Pero it's only slight. Wooden crutch kapag mayroong injury. Injured yung extremities natin. Wala namang injury ah. Loftran crutch, I'll discuss that one later. Answer will be letter B. Cane lang naman. Cane. It's cane. Kapag weak leg. Answer will be letter C. What is loftran crutch? Ito yung ating cane, di ba? At merong bakal dito. Okay? At meron pang parang support sa arm. Ayan. Para yung pasyente. Okay? Ito yung braso niya, hawak dito. Ayan. Ito yung katawan niya. Ayan, di ba? Tapos isa pa. Ayan, dalawa eh. Ayan. May bakal. Tapos parang may brace sa kamay. O, di ba? Ayan, yan yung tatawag na loftran crutch. So, may weakness sa paa at sa kamay. Okay? Yan, to give support ng loftran. But the answer here will be letter D. Cane lang yan. Okay, 46 tayo. A client had stroke. May hemiplegia sa left leg. The straight leg cane formerly used but is not quite efficient now. So, kung hindi gumagana, okay, then we will use quad cane. What's quad cane? Ito po yung straight cane. Yung quad cane po is yung may apat na paa. At is stable, di ba? Siya ay mas stable. Yan ha, letter A. O, 447 tayo. A client who is learning to use a cane is afraid na hala, baka ako'y madulas. Okay? Ako ay madulas. Answer will be letter B. Okay? Kasi the cane has flared tip. Totoo naman, yung baston, yung ilalim niya po, ay may mga ganyan. May mga ganyang bilog sa dulo. Diba? Parang goma ba? Diba? Ayan, letter B is the answer. Okay, 438 tayo. Open leg fracture. Open. Ito yung paa ng pasyente. Ayan. Ito yung buto. Ayan. Ito yung buto niya. Ayan. Ito yung paa ng pasyente. Ayan, di ba? So, may mga organisms na pwedeng pumasok. Ask kung kailan yung huli niyang vaccine ng tetanus. Letter C. Okay? Ayan. 439 naman tayo. Pelvic fracture. Okay? Guys, kapag meron siyang pelvic fracture, meron siyang risk for what? Again, embolism. And that blood clot pwedeng mapunta sa ating lungs or sometimes heart. Diba? Yan. At kapag ito nangyari, okay, yan, we can have what? Basically, shock symptoms. What are shock symptoms? Hypotachy. Okay? Yan. So, answer will be letter A. Hypovolemic shock. Okay, 440. Bony prominence. Ito yung kamay ng patient. Ayan. Ito yung kanyang elbow. Ayan, di ba? Yan, basta kamay yan. Ayan, okay? Yan. So, at meron, kasi, ito, ayan yung cast. Ayan, Diyos ko, na, ayan yung cast. Yan. Ayan yung cast, ha? At kita mo sa loob niya. Tumatawa sa elbow ba? Okay? What can we do? Okay, yan. Answer will be letter D. Have a window cut in the cast. Ibig sabihin, if baling labas na ngayon, ito yung kamay ng pasyente, ito yung isang view niya, ha? Ayan. We will cut a window here para yung elbow niya ay exposed. Pero yung cast, andyan pa rin. Nakuha na, no? Yan. Exposed pa rin to. Ito yung balat ng pasyente. Ito yung balat ng pasyente. Nakuha na, exposed pa rin yan. In other words, we will cut this one. O, diba? Para exposed na lang. Para din magkaroon ng bed sore or ulcer. Pressure ulcer. Yan. Okay, 441. Endo naman tayo. Endocrine naman tayo. Type 1 diabetes. Mga diabetes may 3 piece. Polyuria. Okay. Poly dipsia. Polyphagia. Ihi ng ihi. Inom ng inom. Kain ng kain. So, and there will be letter A. I was thirsty all the time. Polydipsia. Letter A. Okay? A. 442. Which outcome would indicate successful? Okay? Treatment of diabetes insipidus. I told you, mga diabetes, mayroong polyuria, polydipsia, polyphagia. Yan. You will see here na it will be letter A. Less than. Ah, kasi ito, Diyos ko, can he drink almost 2 liters, 2.5 in 24 hours? Mas maganda, babaan mo na lang. Wala na siyang polydipsia. Diba? Letter A is the answer. Okay? Yan. Sorry, ayan. 443. Okay. You determine that insulin to a client with DM at 7 a.m. Okay? What time siya mag-expect na magkaroon ng hypoglycemia? Okay? Ayan. Sagot will be letter C. Oh, look ha. 7. Okay? 7 a.m. Kasi kapag NPH insulin, yung peak niya kasi, okay, is between 8 hanggang 12 hours or 7. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Ayan. Yung peak, binigay mo ba 7 o'clock? Ayan, ayan o, ayan. Yan yung peak niya. Ibig sabihin, mataas yung insulin. And bababa ang ano? Sugar. Kaya dyan manghihina. Ito yung time na manghihina yung pasyente. Kaya dapat meron siyang nakabulsa ng mga snacks or bars sa kanyang packet. Diba? Protein bars whatsoever. Merienda ba? Diba? Yan. Letter C is the answer. Okay. 444 tayo. Requiring insulin. Okay. Mali ang A. Mali ang B. Kasi muscle. No. Kasi ang insulin ay sub-Q. Tissues yan. We don't shake vigorously. We don't shake. Answer will be Dallas is the answer. Draw up the clear insulin first. Ibig sabihin nun may dalawa kasi insulin. Yan. Clear. Cloudy. Yung clear siya ang regular. Ito siguro yung ating NPH. Okay. Yan, siya ay cloudy. Yan. So, meron siyang insulin. May insulin dito. Ito yung takit nila. Ito yung ating syringe. Yan. The number one is inject. Inject air. Saan? Sa cloudy. Let's say you need, kailangan mo ng 10 units. Sa NPH naman, you also need 10 units. And you inject air dito. You inject the air. Pero wag mong idikit yung syringe ha sa insulin. Andyan lang. You inject air. Tapos number 2, aspirate si clear. Inject air. Ito naman, aspirate. And syempre, number 3, aspirate kay cloudy. Kasi yung air na binigay mo kanina dito, automatically, papasok sa kanya na. Diba? Yan. So, ang number 1 rule is inject air. Pangalawa, drop insulin. Clear insulin. Then, pangatlo, aspirate or draw. Diba? Yan, letter D is the answer. Okay, 445 tayo. A client has a serum glucose of 618. Masyado na mataas yan. 80 to 120 dapat yung ating sugar. Pero siya umabot ng 618. So, anong ating priority dyan? Kasi there's a time na baka wala siyang insulin na tinik. Diba? Yan. Anong ating diagnosis? Answer will be letter A. Osmotic diuresis. Letter A. Okay, 446 tayo. Which intervention is most critical sa isang taong may mixed edema coma? Okay? That is hypothyroidism. Answer will be, obviously, prioritize A, B, C. Dallas. Okay? Dallas. Yan. Dallas. Okay, 447 tayo. Again, inguinal hernia years ago. He asked the nurse why he should have this surgery. Parang kwento, no? Na naligaw. Okay? Answer will be letter A. Para hindi masakal yung ating bowel. Because the intestines might protrude. Okay? Sa ating inguinal area. Okay? O, ito yung ating intestines. Ito yung ating katawan. Ito yung ating scrotum. Ito yung paa niya. Intestines, basta, ito yung scrotum, yan yung testicles niya, ayan. Intestines may go here. Tapos, peritoneal muscle, pwedeng maipit, di ba? Letter A, prevents strangulation. Yan. 448 tayo. On the medical surgical floor, the nurse is caring for a cluster of clients so they're diagnosed with DM. Okay. Sino unahin mo? Obviously, yung merong letter D. That can be what? MI. Myocardial infarction. Next. 449 naman tayo. Okay. Diabetes insipidus. Anong problema sa kanya? Answer B, letter A. Anti-diuretic hormone. Okay? Ito kasi yun. Ito yung ating kidney. Yan. Sorry. Pangit yung kidney. Ayan. Yan yung ating kidney. Ureter, bladder. We have here ADH. Anti-diuretic hormone. Ang sabi niya, huy kidney. Huwag kang umihi ng maraming urine. Ang iihi mo lang is 30 to 60 ml per hour. Sabi ni kidney, okay, sure. O sige, 1 hour, I will release 60 urine. After 1 hour, I'll release 60 urine. Kasi sabi yun ni ADH. Okay? Ang problema sa DI is wala siyang ADH. Wala nagsasabi na, uy, bawa, huwag kong sobrahan. Kaya ang kidney, ihi. We have what I call your polyuria. Nandidahan? Nakuha ba? Yan. Sir, what about this one naman? Oh, ito yung kidney natin. Ureter, ito yung bladder. What if ang dami-dami ADH? Ang dami-dami ADH, sumobra naman. Sabi nila, hoy, bawal lumabas. Kahit punong-puno na. Lalabas, super konti lang. Pero maturity yung lalabas. Tawag naman dyan, sayad. Syndrome of inappropriate anti-diuretic hormone. Okay? Anyway, for the question, answer will be letter A. Letter A. Number 15 naman tayo. Hypertension, aldosteronism. Okay? Does diagnosis indicates that the trans hypertension is caused by what gland? Okay? A, B, C, or D. Answer will be letter A. Adrenal cortex. Ito yun ha. Ito yung ating kidney. Yan. Mayroong isang triangle na gland above the kidney. Ang tawag sa kanya is the adrenal gland. Okay? If I will focus on this one, ayan. Ayan. Meron siyang dalawang part. Yung nasa labas, we call it adrenal cortex. Yung nasa gitna, yung nasa middle, we call it medulla. Adrenal cortex. Okay? Yan. Ang nilalabas niya, IGSM. Glucocorticoids, sex hormones, mineralocorticoids. Okay? Ito namang si medulla. Ang nilalabas niya, si men. Okay, ano yung E? Epinephrine or adrenaline. Ito namang N, noradrenaline. So, the question here is aldosteronism, di ba? Oh, isa siyang mineralocorticoid. Kaya ang sagot dito ay adrenal cortex, letter A. Nuggets ba? Okay, yan muna ha. Bye-bye.